Now, I might be biased, but I think that the UK's coastline has some of the best bird watching anywhere in the world. The rugged sea cliffs give home to gannets, fulmars, kittiwakes, and so many other species that are just fantastic to get out to watch. And today is a beautiful day for it. I'm here with a Nikon Monarch M7s, and we're gonna go find what are certainly some of my favorite birds to watch in the UK. Now that has to be one of the UK's best spectacles. You know, just seabirds packed onto the cliffs. You've got kittiwakes, fulmars, there's guillemots, there's even the old black guillemot down the bottom there, shags on the rock, it's just all happening. Scanning an area like this is always fantastic, there's just always loads going on. And you can just spend hours standing just in a spot like this, just enjoying the birds. It's just so wonderful to view them close up through the binoculars. That detail you can grab out from the cliffs, and the more you look into it, the just more birds seem to appear. As I look around the top edge, all of the guillemots that are stacked up, you can see every single ledge on the cliff has loads of just little birds on it. Absolutely wonderful. And all the white heads of the kittiwakes as they drop down the cliff, as they're all absolutely acrobatically just moving around in the mid-ground, is superb. Heading out to sea to feed, come back to the young. God, it is absolutely beautiful to watch. But one seabird in particular that I'm looking for, well, they're not just here. I think I'm gonna have to head a little bit further around the corner to find one of my favorite seabirds in the UK. Now this is what bird watching is all about for me. Amazing, dramatic landscapes filled with some fantastic birds. Got my first eyes on the gannet colony around the corner. Just brilliant, you know, 2 meter wingspan. Incredible diving abilities from like 30 meters from the surface of the water. Look at this fulmar coming around there. Oh, that is brilliant. Just being able to get those close in deep. Oh, wow. They are a spectacular bird. Look at you. Oh. Well, I've moved down the cliff a little because I just couldn't resist the chance to have some even better views of these fulmars. The breeding colony is here with the nests out, so the chicks are out in the open as well. That's great. But just using my binoculars and picking in, these monarchs are giving me a fantastic view of the chicks. All that like downy feathers that you can see, or just close in on the adults that are sat out, you can just really pick out the wonderful textures and details of the patterns on their wing. But also just looking at the nose and the beak, you know, that tube nose of the UK's albatross, the fulmar, it's just wonderful to see so close. And as they absolutely come straight past on the edge, just watching how they just position their wings to fly, just the smallest movements to just send themselves round the bowl in the wind is superb. They just are phenomenal birds to see. And I really am enjoying just the clarity to see them. Well, it's safe to say that half an hour has absolutely flown by. So many great views of them coming around the tops, the chicks and the nests, absolutely superb. But right, as much as I'd love to spend my entire day watching these fulmars, I've got to go see these gannets. Well, I've reached my final location for today, and just in time as the weather's starting to close in. It's great to know that my binoculars are waterproof and that they can last out any conditions. And actually, as I've been coming down the bumpy tracks, I've really liked the fact that the locking diopter means I haven't knocked anything out of focus as well. So when I get here and view, everything is pin sharp and just beautifully clear. The ED glass in the Nikon binoculars is also great at removing and correcting any chromatic aberration. Gives you that real nice clarity and sharpness. It means that on this gannet down here, that's reasonably close, I can see every detail in the feathers, and that beautiful blue ring around the eye, and those stripes of black down the bill. It is detail and close-up views like this that do make you just fall in love with bird watching, especially on the coast. The view over there is phenomenal. The impending rock that sticks out into the ocean. There's thousands and thousands of gannets just all over it, carpeting it completely. With the sea mist rolling in, it really is a fantastic place to be. Well, it's certainly been a fantastic morning bird watching. The cliffs here and the seabirds are just superb. They're absolutely full of gannets, kittiwakes, and my favorite, the fulmars. This certainly is a place I know I'm gonna be spending a lot of time. It's been fantastic hanging out and using the new MONARCH M7s. The clarity and detail to really get some nice close views of some of my favorite birds has been wonderful. Wide field of view for taking it all in, but having that magnification to really see in great detail is superb. And of course, the ruggedness, that no matter what the conditions throw at me, they're gonna last me is great. I think for anybody out there, you've gotta get out and come see some seabirds on the UK coast. It is a phenomenal thing to come and watch. It's never boring for a moment, and there are so many just wonderful birds waiting to be seen. But of course, you want to do it with a good pair of binoculars to really make the most of it.